everybody, it's Laz here in the UK. Beautiful day today, just got back from the gym. And as usual, I look at my emails that I get every day. Well, this is one email upon thousands of emails that I've always gotten of a student, not gonna mention any names, that his bachelor's degree, okay, is not helping him get what he needs to get, all right? The instructors that were in his particular school were telling him to go to YouTube to watch my videos, all right? So he can learn and do whatever. This is from a university, not mentioning names, okay? But let me tell you my experience, I was already teaching out of college. I was teaching server, Cisco, everything, right? But I wanted to get my bachelor's degree. But I didn't want to get it from where the school that I taught. I wanted to get it from another college, which was a county away. So I went over there, and I see that they already had courses in there that I already taught. So I went to the dean of the computer science department, and I said, hey, listen, can I test out of these courses? Because I'm teaching these courses at this college, and I have my certifications. And guess what he says? Certifications are beneath this the level of this college. It was just, it blew my mind. I'm like, okay. So I had to go through, I think through one semester, and after the semester, everybody has to print out, okay, a survey, right? Okay, so they had to find a printer. And it just so happens that the people that were behind me, they already had gone through the whole 4 years, all right? And they were ready to go, right? They had their four-year degree. They were ready to go hit the world running. But what? Guess what happened? They couldn't find a printer. They did not know how to install an IP printer. Well, I had software that would look for IP addresses, whatever. It would look for devices on the network. I found the printer that was in their same floor that was near me. I added the TCPI printer and I printed it out. And I said, here you go. But yet your guys that have their bachelors can't do that. All right. And this was AIU. And if you don't know who AIU was, look them up in Google in Davie, Florida. Okay. And what I'm trying to say is this. I'm all for education. That's just my personal experience. All right. People have many different personal experiences, but this is what I'm saying. You want to go to college, you got the money to go to college, go for it. Go for it. But listen, don't wait 4, 6, 8, 10 years. Then you have your PhD, your master's, whatever it is, and then get out there and get a job. Okay? No. Some employers are being smart now. They're saying, you know what? Certifications is where it's at because they're vendor specific. They get into the nitty gritty of what's happening in a network. Okay? And you got to renew your certifications anywhere between 2 to 3 years. If you're a CCIE, let's say, talking about Cisco, because that's what I teach, obviously. All right. Cisco, if you're a CCIE, is every 5 years, you got to take a written exam. Once you pass the grueling, your first time around, the grueling 8-hour hands-on exam. That not many people pass it the first time. It takes them 2.5 times to pass it. Okay? So get your certs now. That's not going to rape you. Okay? It's going to cost you maybe a couple $100, if that. All right? And you take your test and you get certified. And now they know. You can get Cisco certified, Microsoft certified, CompTIA certified. There's a whole bunch of certifications that are vendor specific that will, when you go to these employers, yes, I know how to do this. Yes, I know how to do that. Because let me ask you this question. And again, this happened to me. I was in charge of the routing portion of, you know, of the school, right? I taught all the routing, so all the networking classes, whatever. I was pretty much the go-to guy. They had an individual that had a master's from the 70s in IT. But he never taught IT and he never worked in the IT field. He worked in the medical field, okay, somehow. And they put him in charge of my Cisco program. And I remember one day he came in and he said, hey, Laz, where are the routers? I go, there they are. And he's looking around. He had no idea. What, they were right on the table. They had no idea. So a guy from that has a degree from the 70s is not up to date. Unless he kept up to date with the technology, it's useless. Nobody uses vacuum tubes anymore. Computers are not the sizes of buildings or rooms. Your cell phones are computers. Hello? Okay? So certifications, definitely. Hey, you got the money? Go to college. More paper, more paper, more paper. That means more ammunition. And then when you go to your interview, you got to sell yourself. That's just the way it is. But it's upsetting to me, and for those of you that have sensitive ears, lower the volume, it's upsetting to me that a person that's paying thousands of dollars and is going to a college or a university, okay, that the professor is telling them, oh, go on YouTube and watch labs. You'll learn how to do this. Seriously? Okay? That's just, I mean, I understand having resources available to you, but you, as an educator, need to go ahead and educate the people in front of you, all right? And unfortunately, I don't see that happening. So this is my, again, my experience that I've, and that's why I have my bachelor's, yes, and I have tons of certifications, yes, but that is an experience because I've been in this for almost 2 decades, okay? So I've been doing it and teaching it. So I can tell you how it is, but don't get discouraged. This is my tip to all of you that are going to college and are struggling. Yes, please watch my YouTube videos, join my boot camps, okay? Get my books that are on Amazon, okay? Or go to my networking doctor site, which you can get the IP book, the only IP book you'll ever need that tells you straight up, okay, how to subnet, summarize, VLSM, all that. For, what is it, $4, $3, something like that? Who knows? I have no freaking idea. Okay? Go there, all right? And you'll see, you'll learn how to do whatever you need to do. Get your cert while you're going to college. So when you go sit in that class, you'll be like, oh, yeah, that's this. Oh, yeah, that's that. They're going to argue with you because people that, listen. I know people that have PhDs. Okay, and you figure, okay, you got a PhD, you probably run your own business, you're a CEO, or I don't know, you're some high up person in a company. No, they work for a person that doesn't have a degree. Because that person was business minded, let's say, right? And they created their own business. But now people with PhDs got to work for him. Because he wants to hire people that are, you know, smart, people that he doesn't have to watch over, right? Because that's what you want to do, you want to hire A people, right? You don't hire CMV people. Guy Kawasaki said that. Oh my God, how do I know that? And I don't have a PhD. Reading is essential, all right? So you got people that have PhDs that sacrifice, and I admire them for doing this. Don't get me wrong. I'm not ridiculing them. I am admiring them that they have their PhDs because they went through a lot of struggle to get that. Not only did they pay a lot of money, all right, they probably still owe, all right? I admire them, but they're working for somebody that has no degree. So what does that say? What does that tell everybody, all right? You get a person that has certifications, and you put them, a person, I'm telling you, I taught people straight out of college that had no idea how to submit, they had no idea how to configure a freaking server. But yet they took networking classes in college. They took IP classes in college and they graduated. I graduated from blase university. I am the man. I threw my cap up in the air and now I'm this. Really? Get in front of that server and see if you know what you're doing. They have no friggin' clue. I don't want to turn this into a rant or a long thing. It's just upsetting because I see emails like this every day. I see very qualified people, all right, that are not getting jobs or getting jobs that don't need to be working at, that should, you know, get into their IT field and be people in charge in their IT field. So this is my, again, my tip to you. As you go through college, okay, make time. You have 24 hours in a day. Don't give me no more excuses. You have 24 hours in a day to study for your certs, practice for your certs. There's free stuff out there. Go to Cisco Academy, All right, you can download the package tracer doing Cisco. All right, if you're in school, tell them, hey, can I use the lab? So you can work with servers. All right, get all these things. Yeah, go to YouTube. Go to YouTube. There's a million people out there on YouTube, to include myself, that is giving you free stuff to know and know how to do. Or go to these e-learning platforms like globed.net. I got classes in there galore. All right, that you can go ahead and purchase for close to nothing. All right, and you can learn how to do things. All right, and believe me, when I was going through college, I purchased, okay, from a website, video courses that was straight to the point. This is how you do this, XYZ, XYZ, XYZ. When I went inside to take that class, I told the instructor what was going on. But again, you gotta take it upon yourself. You gotta go ahead and say, you know what? I gotta take responsibility for my own education. Because let me tell you, like this email I got today, I feel so bad. There's thousands of people out there that are more than qualified to be in the IT field, and they're not because some HR person said, well, you know, I don't think you have enough, whatever. It's BS. Luckily, again, some employers have gotten smart and they said, hey, let the IT manager interview the IT people. And then, okay, well, now I'm talking to a colleague. I'm talking to somebody that knows, all right? But anyway, I just wanted to share this with you because, again, it's just ridiculous. Summarize real quick, and I'll let you guys go. Go to globed.net. Go to Amazon and Google my name, Lazaro Diaz, and you'll see my books there. Go to YouTube and look up The Networking Doctors. You'll see all my videos on all the different things you can do, plus every other, or just IT in general, and you can see what's there. And believe me, it'll help you as you're going through your college IT curriculum, okay? So I'm sorry for the rant and my yelling, for those of you that have sensitive ears, but I just had to get that out there. Good luck, everyone.